So now that we know what the definition of orthogonal vectors is, let's go ahead and come up with some special equations that let us easily compute an orthogonal vector given some vector. For the special case of vectors in R2, we'll work with R2 in this video, and then in the next video, we'll do something very similar for R3. So our strategy here is I would like to be able to easily compute some orthogonal vector if you hand me a vector from R2. So let's start off kind of generically. Let's pick our vector V as an arbitrary two-dimensional vector in R2. So its two coordinates are V1 and V2. And I want to find all of the vectors that are orthogonal to V. So I'm going to say that my vector that I'm about to find is X, and I'm going to require that X is orthogonal to V. And we know what orthogonal means. We know that orthogonal vectors have a dot product of zero. So I'm going to enforce the dot product between X and V being zero, which means that I need X1 times V1 plus X2 times V2 equals zero. Which means basically I need these two things to cancel out, right? Whatever X1 V1 is, I need X2 V2 to be the negative of that value. If that's the case, then these will indeed add up to zero, and I'll have a vector X that is orthogonal to V. So these products need to have the same magnitude, but need to be opposite in sign. So let's just go ahead and try something. Let's say I'm gonna go ahead and pick X1 as V2 and X2 as a negative V1. So I'm choosing X1 to be whatever value this is, and then X2 is gonna be V1, but negative in sign. So it's kind of like I'm flipping the dimensions and negating one of the dimensions. If I do that, look what happens. I can replace X1 with V2, and I can replace X2 with a negative V1, and then these products cancel out just like I want. So one thing I can see right away is that if you hand me a vector V that contains coordinates V1 and V2, X, where I've just flipped the coordinates and negated one, is indeed going to be orthogonal. So let's just look at an example of that. If you give me the specific vector 3, 4, I know that X, if I flip the dimensions, so put the 4 up top, put the 3 down low, and then negate that second dimension, that X will indeed be orthogonal to V. But there's one more little kind of wrinkle I didn't consider. I kind of arbitrarily chose which sign to put here, right? I could have easily come back to here and let X1 be a negative V2 and X2 be positive V1. So kind of where I put that sign was somewhat arbitrary. There's actually another solution here. X equaling a negative V2, V1 is also a solution. So I still flip the dimensions, but which one I negate is kind of up to me. And that kind of makes sense. If you draw a vector in R2, you can definitely picture two different orthogonal vectors. As an example, if your starting vector was the x-axis, the y-axis going up is orthogonal, and the y-axis going down is orthogonal, right? So it's kind of up to you which direction that you go along that perpendicular dimension. So the other vector here is also a negative 4, 3. So given this vector in R2, I flip and I negate either the second dimension or the first dimension. Both of those are going to be orthogonal to my initial starting vector. Let's do another example. If you give me the vector a negative 2, 1, I can find two vectors that are orthogonal to this, namely 1, negative 2, and negative 1, negative 2, right? On this first one, I flipped and I negated the second dimension. On this first one, I flipped and I negated the first dimension. So we can always find two orthogonal vectors to some given vector in R2. All right, so a pretty easy little equation. Kind of remember these. If you ever need to find an orthogonal vector, it's a pretty handy way to come about that in R2. In the next video, we'll do a similar exercise and come up with kind of a generic equation for finding orthogonal vectors in R3.